Now let's get to solving the problem, coding it up. But before I do that, I want to introduce one more piece of jargon, which is if I'm at a particular state and I decide that that's the one, that's the endpoint of the path that I want to expand, and I come up with the states you can get to from there by expanding the path and the steps that it takes to get to those states, I call that the successors to this state. So the successors is a collection of states that you can reach and the steps that it took to get there. Here's my solution. It's a little bit complicated, so let's go through it step by step. I'm saying the input to this poor problem function are x and y, which are the capacity of the glasses. I'm using capital X and y for that. Then the goal, which is going to be an integer, like 6, to say that's how much I'm trying to get to, and that can be in either one of the glasses. And then the start state, which I'm defaulting to 0 and 0, saying both glasses have current level 0. But if you wanted, you could generalize the problem and pass in something else as what we're starting with. And I'm using lowercase x and lowercase y to indicate the current capacity of the glasses. So here I check and see, are we done before we even get going? Did you, give me a start state and said, well, the goal is to have a glass with the 0 in it, then we're done before doing any actions. So go ahead and return that. And what I'm going to return is called a path. And the path is an alternation of states and then an arrow, which will give a name to each action, and then the other state that it goes to. And we alternate out with states, action states, and so on. So here, if there's nothing to do, it's just a state with no actions. We're going to keep track of the states that we've already explored, and that's going to be a set. We're going to keep track of the frontier, and conceptually that's a set too, but we're going to pull the items off of the frontier one at a time, and so I've made it an ordered list rather than a set, so I know which element of the frontier do I want to explore first. And so a frontier, the explored is a set of states, and the frontier is an ordered list of paths. And the only path we have so far is the trivial path that says we're starting at the start and we haven't gone anywhere else yet. So that's what we start our frontier with. While the frontier is left, while there's still frontier states that we haven't explored from yet, we pop off the first one. So pop of 0 says take the 0th element of the list. So we're going to pull elements off of the front of the list and push them onto the end of the list. Then say the current state is the last element of the path. So the path goes from one state to the next, and the last element of the path is the current state. So let's take x and y from there. Then I've defined a successor function that gives me all the successor states and the actions we used to get from there. So there should be 6 of those. And then if we say if that new state is not explored, then it's something new. If it was explored, there's nothing left to do. We've already explored from there. If it hasn't been explored yet, then add it to the explored set, make up a new path, which consists of the old path, plus we follow an action to get to the new state. If the goal number is somewhere in that state, so the goal is 6, and the state is the two levels of the glasses, say 6 and 3, yes, 6 is in 6 and 3, then we're done. Return that path as the winner, the path that reached the goal. Otherwise, just add this path onto the frontier, and we'll pull something off of the frontier later. And if we go all the way through and we run out of frontiers to explore from, then we can't reach the goal, and we return fail. You could have fail be none. I decided to make it be the empty list because all the other things we were returning were lists. Either way, none or fail, both are equivalent to false in Python if statements, so probably either one would do fine. And here's my successor function. So it takes the current levels of the glasses and the maximum capacity of the glasses, and what it's going to return is a dictionary of state action pairs. And the state is just an XY pair of what are the levels of the glasses going to be, and the action is how you got there. And we're just going to use strings to represent those actions, so it's just something that we can print out that are otherwise unimportant in the operation of the program. And first I wanted to check that this is a legal state, that the fill level of X is less than its capacity, and same for Y. And then I said, here are the 6 possibilities. And the pouring is complicated. Let's do the filling first. So the filling says you can fill X up to its capacity, capital X. You can fill Y up to its capacity, capital Y. You can empty X, that'll become zero. You can empty Y, it will become zero. And then the fill, there's two cases. If the total amount of water is less than Y, then you can take all the water in the first glass, which is X, and add it into Y, so you get Y plus X. Same thing in the other direction. But if the total amount of water is more than the destination that you're trying to pour it into, then you can only pour as much as will fill up the other glass. And we can see that there's conservation of water here. The total amount is X plus Y minus this difference plus this difference. And I got the definition of my program pretty much just by following out the implications of this diagram, that we're going to keep track of an explored set, never try to return there, expand a frontier, pop off one element of the frontier, add in the new elements, and check when we get to the goal. And then that was all kind of generic for any exploration problem. And then for the specific water problem, the successor function and the way that was laid out, that was specific to what we're doing with the glasses.